And the rain expected in Sacramento may be a good test for a new pipe system that's underneath I-5.
That was installed during the Big Fix project this summer. Our old friend Mark Dinger with Caltrans joins us now in the HD newsroom. So how much rain, Mark, will you need in order for you guys to be able to say, aha, we got this thing done right?
Well, I tell you, we need some sustained rain over a couple of days, and judging from Eileen's forecast, it looks like that's just what we're going to get coming into Monday, Tuesday, the early part of next week. We want to see how the new drainage pipes are working, how our new monitoring pumps are working, and also how our new drainage pumps there are working. So we want to see it over the long term and test it just right.
Mark, I almost hesitate to ask this, but what if it didn't work?
What if it didn't work?
Yeah.
We'd be in big trouble, but we put some careful engineering into that. So far, it's worked pretty well. We had a rain event back in September, and with the exception of some clogged drains up on the top part of the surface, what lies beneath worked very well. In fact, it was outstanding.
Mark, we used to see the dreaded ponding in certain areas of that boat section. Obviously, this is a lot of what was done in order to fix that. So if there's any area that would flood, would it be that area again? Not that it will flood.
Well, what we're going to be keeping an eye on is really those light right lanes of northbound I-5 especially, right? They're approaching J Street. That was a traditional trouble spot. It didn't fill up last time, and we're hoping that's going to take place over the weekend, too. So we're pretty confident things are going to work out there.
Mark, just at the top of your name, we can see you're wearing a little black ribbon there today. It's in memory of someone, is it not?
Yes, it is, Walton. Thanks for asking. Today at our Elk Grove maintenance facility, our local maintenance forces will be remembering Matt White, a Sacramento who lost his life along our Highway 99 in Elk Grove last year during a pothole operation. We're going to remember why that accident occurred and what we need to do to be more careful out there in the future, and really a grim reminder to motorists to slow for the cone zone, slow for our winter forces out there this weekend too, because somebody might not be home for the holidays if
right.
you don't.
Right. Okay. I remember covering that story, and again, our condolences to the White family, and it's a great thing that you guys are doing to remember a fallen comrade there. Okay. Mark Dinger, thank you. Good luck with the rain and the pump.
You bet.
All right.